This video is brought to you by the Brown Lab at Virginia Tech. Hey everyone, in this video, we're going to go over the Chimera X user interface and some of its options. You can use the chapters or the timestamps in the description to skip to each part of the tutorial. Links to everything will be posted below. Let's start by opening up a practice molecule. You can click the Get Started link in the main interface and click Open to BBV to open this practice molecule. The left mouse rotates the model. The middle mouse, or scroll, can zoom in and out, and the right mouse moves the model around transitionally. Feel free to pause the video here if you want more practice moving models around. If you want to take a snapshot of this model, you can hit the button in the top, or you can use the command line. The command line simply types save, file path, the file name, and the extension. If for any reason you forget, you can always type help and save, and it'll pull up a window with more information. Let's take a look at some of the options in the graphical menu. Here, you can open molecule files or Chimera sessions, open recent files, save Chimera session files, images, or molecule files. Snapshot only takes a screenshot of the interface, and Spin Movie records a 360 video of the molecule. Now let's take a look at the molecule display. Here, you can hide and show atoms, hide and show cartoons to show the backbone of the protein, and hide and show the surface of the model. We can also change the appearance of atoms and nucleotides here. We can use sticks, spheres, or ball and stick models. You can change the color of the model here or in the top under the Actions tab. Heteroatom colors by element, with nitrogen being blue and oxygen being red. Rainbow colors every residue a different color of the rainbow. And chain colors each chain a different color. Now, let's go to the Graphics tab. These settings affect the appearance and view of the model and background. By default, a black background is given with simple lighting, no shadows, and no silhouettes. Under background, we can change the background to white, gray, or black. We can go ahead and leave it at gray right now. Lighting and effects changes the appearance of the model. Simple is a default texture with subtle lighting. Soft is a matte texture with little lighting. Full is a three-dimensional rendering with lots of lighting. Flat is a flat representation of the model. Shadows toggles whether the model projects a shadow. And silhouettes toggles a black outline around the model. I'm going to use the full effect. Camera changes the view of the model. View all fills the view with all visible models. Orient returns the model to its default orientation and camera angle. Side view provides a second view of the protein from 90 degrees to the right to better orient the molecule in space. Let's try the orient feature. If you're having problems lining up your molecule, just go ahead and click the Orient button to return to the original position. Let's take a look at the Right Mouse tab. Each of these settings redefines the function of the right mouse. We can select a single atom by clicking Select and right-clicking on the atom. Simply right-click again off of the atom to unselect it. You can also click and drag to select a section. Simply right-click off again to unselect. Rotate allows you to rotate the model the same as the left mouse button. Translate moves the model around without rotating, same as clicking the middle mouse button. Zoom allows you to zoom in and out by right-clicking and dragging the mouse. Using the distance tool, we can measure and label the distance between two atoms by right-clicking each of them once. We can label these two atoms with their three-letter code by selecting Label and clicking on each of them. We can move these labels to a better position by clicking Move Label and dragging them to an ideal spot. Let's orient the model and go over some other menu options. The options under File are primarily for opening and saving files. The open and save functions act the exact same as the open and save commands from the home menu of the graphical menu section. Select allows for selection of certain parts of the visible model. By visible model, this means a model which is currently loaded into the session, whether it is seen in the main interface or not. Chains allows you to select individual chains from the model. Chemistry allows you to select all of a particular element or functional group. Residues allows you to select a particular type of residue, both amino acids and nucleotides. Structure allows you to select the backbone, side chain, ligands, or secondary structures. Clear clears the current selection. Invert deselects all selections and selects everything not selected. All selects everything visible. The Actions menu contains display options very similar to the Molecule Display menu of the Graphical Menus section, but provides a few more options. Atoms and Bonds allows you to show or hide atoms or bonds, and change the style shown. Cartoon allows you to show or hide cartoons of the backbone, and changes the appearance of alpha helices and beta sheets. Surface allows you to show or hide the surface of the model, change how the surface is displayed, and change transparency. Color allows you to change the color of a selection. For more color options, select all options. Label allows you to set labels and edit label settings. The tool menu contains options for editing and analyzing the structure of a model. General gives options for tabs you can open. By default, the log, model panel, and command line interface are active. Sequence allows for a blast search of the sequence. Structure analysis allows detection of clashes, distances, and H-bonds. It also allows superimposing two proteins using the matchmaker feature. Let's take a look at the model panel and the five major components. The name column gives the name of every model in use. When using crystals from the protein databank, this is given as the PDB code. But if the PDB file is loaded, this will name the model by its file name. In the ID column, every model is given a number used to identify it. When referring to a model in the command line, refer to it by its ID. For example, view pound 1. The third column is the color column. Here, you can change the color of a whole model. Click on the box to select a color to change the color of the model. To color a specific part of the model, or only a selection, use the Actions menu in the top left. The next column is the Shown column. This makes models visible or invisible in the selection. While a model is invisible, settings changed will not affect that model. Finally, the Selected column selects and deselects entire models. Models selected completely will have a check in the box. Models that have part of them selected, but not the entire model, we'll have a square in this box. Let's quickly go over the log again before we continue. The log shows how each action would be performed using the command line. You can copy and paste a command from the log into the command line to recreate a button action. All blue words are commands, and clicking on them opens up a help menu for that command. The log also displays information about each chain and model when they are loaded. Remember that the log does not save when you close the program. Thanks for watching. Be sure to check out the next video about using commands to create good visualizations.